Is she live?
I'm live.
Oh.
All right, so we're here today to talk about Ghost Town, which is our brand new game that's now open. Emma, do you want to tell us what the game is about?
All right, so this game Ghost Town is an outdoor adventure. It takes you around the streets of downtown Kingston and shows you some of the most haunted locations in the entire city. We go through some grave sites, some parks that have a suspicious amount of bodies underneath them, and we bring you back here to finish off the game in a very epic way. The backstory is you are paranormal investigators, and you're investigating a large amount of recent paranormal activity within the city.
Awesome. So how many players right now can the game accommodate?
I'm going to say 2 to 6.
Awesome. Devin, what's your favorite part about this game so far?
The ending will always be my favorite part of this game.
Yeah,
but also the walk, because walking is really nice too.
I think the ending is my favorite part of any game we've ever done.
Same.
Yeah. What, without any spoilers, I miss Adam's face. Without any spoilers, what makes this ending so great? Adam.
Ooh, no spoilers?
How?
No spoilers?
No spoilers.
Like teaser spoiler?
You can do a teaser spoiler, but I would say no actual spoilers.
I don't know the difference.
Boss battle. Boss
battle.
Okay, but you basically made up the term boss battle.
I did not make up
the
term.
That's not
a
real thing.
Yeah, I've taken the term from video gaming and just applied it to escape rooms.
Okay, so
and I didn't even do it. It's a very common term.
Okay, so then what exactly does that mean then?
Essentially, you go through and level up your skills as the game progresses until you're ready to fight the final boss, and then you fight him. Think video game.
Cool. So, is this game family friendly because it is about ghosts?
Yes.
There's a content warning advised on it, just because we do talk about death, and there are ghosts, and there's some like dark spaces to the game, but anyone who wants to play is able to play it.
I would say if you played The Cure, this is
a step
more
down
family
and scary.
Friendly than The Cure.
Yeah.
It would be like, catch me outside, level or lockdown, Mayan, Ghost Town, Cure, Coroner's Report. And Coroner's Report is so far down the list that it's almost not even fair to have it on this list.
I'd call it spooky, not even scary.
Yeah, yeah. And like enough fun.
Even spooky is like a stretch. There's little elements.
Like if you let your kids go out on Halloween night,
then
there's no reason why kids couldn't do this.
Halloween is scarier than this game, but not as cool. And I love Halloween.
Yeah.
That's probably true.
Also a 90-minute experience, or up to 90-minute experience. So it's different than everything we've ever done.
Awesome. So what does up to 90-minute experience mean?
So it can take you up to 90 minutes to complete it, but I'm going to assume most people are going to complete it before then. The game is going to run on a stopwatch, not a timer kind of scenario, so you come back and get your final time, but you will most likely not be stopped while playing the game.
Awesome. Cool. When does the game actually open?
Not this Friday, but next.
Awesome. And do you guys have anything else to say about the game?
Oh, gosh.
If
you're scared of doing an outdoor game, because it's not like you think, I'd rather be in a room to do an escape room, definitely play this game. And like Emma had said, and Devin said it was her favorite part, the ending is definitely the strongest thing.
But the whole thing is very
good. Yeah, and the whole thing is good. But if you're, like, it's definitely worth playing.
Yeah.
The little bit of the indoor portion you have is powerful.
Also, I think the props are just worth coming and seeing. They're absolutely amazing. We won't tease them too much, but everything we're creating for this game, we're creating in-house, and it's just to the next level.
Awesome. All right, we'll leave it here. Thanks, guys.